University now offers a detailed look at what life was like at a regional Japanese internment camp during World War II.
Well, reporter Cindy Cha tells us how family ties are the reason of a historic collection images making their way to Pullman.
Patty Hirahara looks at a yearbook that once belonged to her father. The book is part of a collection she donated to WSU. But it's the images depicting life at a Japanese internment camp that are at the center of the collection. Her father and grandfather took more than 2,000 photos at Heart Mountain in Wyoming from 1943 to 1945. The photos were taken with a journalistic style, describing what life was really like during that time.
When you talk to people, they have a very different perspective of camp. They think it's dark, they think it's dreary, they didn't think the internees had a life. And when they see these pictures, they see dances, they see people in Boy Scouts, they see normal life.
They've been tucked away for years, but now these images have a new home. Patty chose to donate her vast collection of these images to Washington State University, and for a good reason. It's her father's alma mater. Trevor Bond of WSU knew this collection would generate great interest among students and faculty.
The response has been amazing. We've had very large turnouts for our events associated with the collection, and so it's very exciting.
Being the last descendant of four generations that lived in America since 1909, Patty says it's up to her to preserve the history of her ancestors. And though it's been known this collection will be her family legacy, Patty doesn't see it that way.
We have been the family to be the catalyst to open the doors for other family stories to be told, and that this is really a tribute to the internees that lived in Heart Mountain from 1942 to 1945.
And a tribute to a young man who once saw life at a Japanese internment camp through his lenses. In Pullman, Cindy Cha, KLEW News.
Thank you, Cindy. WSU also received a grant from a National Park Service to digitize more than 1,000 of the images so people can view them online. The images are expected to be available in October of 2012.